the professor. I greet you all in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. Are you having a good time? Amen. I'm going to talk to you on a subject. Struggling also. What do you share with young people? Because young people of today are so advanced and they know so many things. And it's never easy to then share with young people because they know something. So I thought maybe let's talk about something that is very, very relevant. So I've decided to talk on the subject, how to be a Joseph when Jacob is your father. How to be a Joseph when Jacob is your father. And I'm using Jacob as a negative and Joseph as a positive. It's quite funny, you know, I know Pastor Moy would know this, and Pastor got it that time. My favorite, all-time favorite character in the Bible is Jacob. Least favorite character in the Bible is Joseph. I don't like Joseph at all. I mean, pray for me. God bless you as you like Joseph. Because, you see, Joseph, you can't find him in real life. He stays in the Bible. It's like Jesus. They're Bible people. But Jacob, he can easily be the person sitting next to you. You can even read about him in H Metro. But what I want you to see is, for Jacob to be Jacob, he's a guy who starts when things are bad. His name alone means a thief, a conman, a deceiver. You know, in Jeremiah 17, when the Bible says the heart is deceitful above all things, the word that is used there in Hebrew for deceitful is Jacob. The heart is Jacob. So already his name signifies deception of the highest order. But don't be too hard on Jacob, because you need to know where Jacob is coming from. And where is he coming from? Look at his history. Look at his background. Because no, whether you like it or not, your background is a downforce that brings you down. It doesn't matter whether you have got a high mental aptitude and your mental thrust is up there. That your mental aptitude can even power a rocket to go out of space. But background is a downforce. I love car racing, you know. May God bless you. May God bless you. God bless you. So when you look at F1 cars, at the back of any F1 car, there is a spoiler which is called a wing. It creates what is called a downforce. Because those things can move from, you know, in a second, it's 300 kilometers per hour. Without that downforce, it can fly. But you need that downforce because of aerodynamics, so that the faster it goes, the quicker it can brake, and the more it stays on the ground. It can never overturn. And an aeroplane also has a wings. That creates a downforce. But the downforce of an aeroplane helps the aeroplane to take off. But the downforce of an F1 car helps the car to stay. And your background can take you up. It can make you stay on the ground. Let's look at Jacob. Let's just look at his background. Let's just do a biographical analysis of the historical background of Jacob. Sekuru vake vakadanana nemaid and impregnated the maid. After the maid and the mother had arranged it, and a child was born. Not only did his grandfather impregnated the maid, he also had other women who are classified into two groups of maids and concubines. When you hear the Old Testament talking about maids, it's not talking about house helpers. When the Bible says, thou shalt not lust covet your neighbor's maid servant, go and Google what the maid servant means. So his grandfather not only had concubines. Concubines are domestic prostitutes. They can't be shared. They are just Go and Google. Don't take what I'm saying. You know, you can't be trusting these professors. Just go and Google. So his his grandfather is coming from there. Then goes to my cousin, Vanalot. He starts up a whole generation from impregnating his own daughters. Ndiyakavisa umandara wevana vake. That's where Jacob is coming from. We are talking about the grandfather. His father and mother had family politics. And you know how what happens when mothers and fathers are fighting. And many a times, when our parents fight, the battleground of their fight becomes the children. All of you are coming from families where they are run like mafia families. Where the mother takes sides with the boys, and the mother or the father takes, you know, with the girls. And, you know, it's like a mafia state of a family. Where you are negotiating to say, okay, for us to win this. And you all here have become little demons that now know how to manipulate your parents. You know that if you want an iPhone 14 from your father, you manipulate this way and that way and this way on that issue of your other sister who's in South Africa, and she's been studying sociology for the past 13 years, and you know, you... And let me tell you something, right on the onset, of course we are past the onset, each and every family has its own drama. If you think that where you're coming from is drama, you have not seen drama. Oh, I've never seen my father. That's not drama. That's just family matters. That's not drama. The mother liked him, Jacob. The father liked Esau. The father is about to die. He says, okay, go and hunt. The mother hears and says, no, he's not going to win. You are the one who's going to win. He says, no. So how am I going to win? He says, get the sheep. He said, but if my father gets it and you curse me, he said, no, may your curse be upon me. Have you ever seen children who participate in the fight between their parents? Because no, if you want this one, if you want the mother to say yes, go through the girl, the last born. She's the one who's getting the key to unlock the heart of the mother. And they managed to convince, and coming from a family of deceivers. And they managed to deceive the father. And then he realized that, oh, we've been deceived here. Blessings have gone by deception. And that is the worst thing. You know, the worst thing about church people is they do satanic things using verses. So, no. There is a God to heaven. There is a God in heaven on this issue. When you are being satanic and diabolical at the same time, but you'll be using Bible verses to push agendas that splits the family into tatters. And the mother heard and went and said, Jacob, they've decided to dismember you. And the dismembering was not what you do in your church books where they just remove your name in the church books. No, it was a proper literal dismembering of body parts. Killing. And the mother said, run. Yeah. Run. Where? Where I came from. Yeah. All right. Where I came from. There in Mesopotamia. Yeah. All of the Chaldeans. This is where, when you allow family drama to reach levels that has never been reached, people will flee from Canaan and find refuge in Babylon. And this is what happened to Jacob, because they wanted to slaughter him in Canaan. And for him to be safe, Babylon. I says, where are you going? To my people. And all of us here, when you look at our fathers, relative from the father's side and relative from the mother's side, it's like MDC and ZANU-PF. Baba, useless. No. That's Jacob's story. No, they care. To waka tirira isi takari wana seku. Hama zaba bongo antiti kana kuwa wana. Baka ndirambai. And some of the fights that you are fighting fights of people who are dead. You are fighting the fight of your mother who died. And you are not supposed to participate because you were not there when they had a misunderstanding with your father. You did not see. You were not even a spectator. And you come and you want to be the superstar of that fight. You want to be soccer player of that fight. He went and stayed. Nana Seguruak. They wanted to kill me. So they were deceivers. And this is why the mother also was a deceiver. Because what she learned where she came from, her background was a background of deceivers who were diabolical through and through. So he works for 7 years for a beautiful lady that he wanted. On the wedding day, the uncle then says, Wuno mzukuru. Wuno Mesopotamia. Mukuru si. Hanga tangiri wuno mduku. Iweka na washida mduku. Chitangu watora mkuru. Uyozo, shanda wa mamu makuri. That is the story of Jacob. And Ellen White has highlighted that you come into life with inherited weaknesses. From the mother's side, he's inheriting deception. From the father's side, he's inheriting conniving and politics and strategizing and. So he's just a heap of mess. He's a time bomb that is waiting to blow. You fall in love with Jacob at the peril of your life. We are talking about Joseph. But we are just looking at his the father and the grandfather and the uncles. After he worked for 7 years, worked for another 7 years, and then he saw that nothing is coming in. Worked for another 21 years. He's got nothing to his name. And he has nowhere to run to. So what then happens? He says, for me to win here, I have to start doing what I do best. Deceive. Yeah. The way he's doing things, we wrote the handbook. Introduction to deception, we wrote that handbook. This boy is a thief. And one day he wakes up, that's what the Bible says, and he saw that his uncle's face was not friendly as it was. And he knew he had to leave. And do you know, if we ask you, where do you come from? He said, no. Actually, we came from Mashingo. Originally, it was from Mashingo. But now we then shifted and we are now in Mashonaland Central. It's because your own father's father, your great-grandfather, was running away from their relatives who wanted to kill them. Because I am going to Mzaraban in Kanyemba, where not even one of my relatives is there, so that I can start on a clean page. Because if they find me, they will kill me. And that's your background. Where you know that your father's brothers want to kill him. Now, where he came from, they want to kill him. Where he found refuge, they want to kill him. So what does he do? He ran away. Now, but before he ran away, I'm talking about Joseph's father. He then got married. The first woman that he loved, he was deceived and he was given the one that he didn't love. So now he has two wives who are sisters.
And there are people who are listening to me here who understand what I'm talking about. That your grandfather married sisters. And children who are coming from such families.
They hate each other. At any given moment, they will kill each other without thinking twice. So when they got married, this woman who is married, who is the first wife in this family, was not loved. But she's the one who's got the kids. This one who's loved, no children. So what does this one do? She then goes and talks to the maid. To my husband. When the maid got a child, she says she's now mine. And when Leah also saw what her young sister had done, she also took a maid. The child is now mine. So when you talk about the 12 sons of Jacob, they are coming from 4 different women. And there is MDC and ZANU-PF in that. Leah and her maid, the kids stand as a political party. And of course, that is government of national unity. Where the children of the wife and the children of the maid are 2 political parties that have to join as they sit in the parliament against this other political party. But these other political parties weak because Rachel is beautiful but barren. And that is the secret of life, that you can be beautifully barren. That's a sermon on its own. But Leah, ugly as she was, children. Have you ever seen that? That's another sermon. That many times, God advertises beauty as ugly. And the devil advertises ugly as beautiful. The only sister from this family is a young lady called Dinah. She falls in love with these useless guys called the Shechemites. She's raped. Imagine coming from a family where that tete was tete muri. Raped. And the brothers, when they saw that their sister had been raped, they said, it's okay, don't worry. Don't worry. You raped our sister, it's okay. Let's just sanctify this and make things right. Just circumcised. When you're circumcised, you give us our lobola money and we become relatives. The Shechemites didn't know that they are dealing with people who are a 4th generation of deceptors. They're PhDs of deception, those brothers. Shechemites were circumcised happily. Little did they know that after circumcision, they were going to be circumcised of their necks. They were killed. You know, they were slaughtered. You should read the story in Genesis 32. They were slaughtered. And when the father saw that they had been slaughtered, he said, now, where are we going to go? From my father's side, they want to kill me. From my mother's side, they want to kill me. Where we found refuge, they want to kill us. Where do we go? As they are running away, the firstborn in the family falls in love and has an affair with the father's prostitute. No, not with the father's wife. I want you to know that. On top of 4 wives, he also had concubines. So Reuben now falls in love with one of his father's prostitutes. That's already wrong. You know, it's one thing for your father to have a side chick. But for your brother to have an affair with your father's side chick, that's family drama. You're complaining, oh my father has done this. No, listen. That's kindergarten family drama. There are kids who are here, they are walk with the shame and embarrassment of their father's sexual promiscuity. But that's kindergarten drama. So Joseph starts in. He's born now into a family where there's already MDC and ZANU-PF, and within MDC and ZANU-PF, it's government of national unity. So he's born into this family where he is born not to make it. And let me tell you something. Every family has its own drama. At one time, when Pastor Machamira was being ordained, I was asked to introduce him. And I had to call upon all the eloquence that I had learned to introduce him. And when I was giving background of Pastor Tatenda Machamira, our executive secretary, people were shocked to find that Pastor Machamira is a pastor. His father is a pastor. So that's two generations of pastors. His mother is a msoshi. And all the msoshis, they are pastors. The mother to Tatenda Machamira is also married to a pastor. When Machamira decided to get married, he then married a pastor's daughter. And this pastor's daughter has brothers who are pastors. Even that family full of pastors has drama. And you think about where there are pastors and professors. You know, Professor Msoso is the only African I know who wrote a Sabbath school quarterly. That's where Machamira is coming from. When professors have drama, what more? Deaconless families. Now, have you ever seen that? These brothers, 12 of them, hate each other. But the only time when they suspend hatred for each other is when they have collective hatred for Joseph. Have you ever seen people who don't like each other? They only like each other because they share a common hatred for you. Like Pilate and Herod. They were not friends. What joined them was their common hatred for Jesus. You know, there are people who don't like you. They only like you. They would never want to talk eye to eye. But what brings them together is their common hatred for you. That's Joseph. And some of you are born into families where there is hate, there is suspicion, and you are not going to make it. Because the downforce that is bringing you down is your own blood. And let me tell you something. A man's greatest enemies are not people who are not coming from your family. Your own brothers. Because in every brother, there is a destructive other. It's Cain and Abel. The first people that we know. 9 months is Cain and Abel. They slaughtered each other. It's the story of Jacob and Esau. It's the story of Joseph and his brothers. It's the story of David and his brothers. Brothers who hate each other. And when we are talking about, we are not just talking about families. Go and look at pastors. It's a pastor and a pastor crime. Pastors and pastors want each other's neck. You will never find elders fighting with pastors on higher levels. Right? It's pastor to pastor fight. Elder to elder. You will never find deacons fighting with the elders. No, no, no. My deacon, when politics is over, what's the deacon? You will never find a war between preachers and singers. No, never. Group here, nearly group here. We are going to impose questions. My notes are bent. Singers and singers cry. So what you then find is they hate Joseph. Even when Joseph becomes the messenger that brings blessings, they say, we want the blessings, but not the messenger. He's sent to Dothan, Genesis chapter 37. And the father then says to him, "Change." And some of you are coming and all of your brothers don't like you because they know you are the parents' favorite. It was never the plan of God. Because when the to my last born. ndiye akatengerwa the coat of many colors. Vamwe asina vachifamba vachienda kuchikoro so vasina butsu. Vana vanotoziva kuti we are second citizens, second class citizens in the family where we are coming from. Ende iwone kuzoenda kwakaita kuchikoro kanodzidza law ku South Africa. Hauchatotangike mhuri imomo. You are last born, but you are talking family, ka first born. Yeah, actually, according to constitutional law. Yeah. There is actually a new, I think it's act what, chapter what? It's against that idea. So I'm just advising the family on legal grounds. They know, your brothers and sisters, they know nothing will work in the family until you have said yes. And you think they will like you. They won't. Coat of many colors. You think when you then come, let's kill him. Chapter 37, verse 19. And when they saw him from afar, they said, behold, the dreamer cometh. Behold now, let us slay him and see what shall become of his dream. When brothers sit down to plan and connive over the downfall of another brother. His family is where we are coming from. Now, let's kill him. The only person who defended Joseph was the firstborn of the family because of his veto power. It's Reuben. He says, no, we can't do that. We can't literally kill him. Let's just throw him into a pit so that he dies slowly. You know what has happened? It has happened to you that your name was discussed when you were not there, and the person who defended you was actually advocating for a more prolonged punishment which brought slow death. Even coming from such a family, you can be a Joseph when Jacob is your father. People talk about my mother, my father. You know, Joseph never saw the mother. The mother actually died when Benjamin was born. So he is a child who coming in from a single parent home. And most of these people coming from single parents are damaged goods. Not most, all of them. They have a downforce of either lacking a father figure or lacking a mother figure. Damaged goods. And it's because of their damage that either they become successful or they become successfully failures. That's the story of Adolf Hitler. Single home. It's the story of Robert Mugabe. Single home. It's the story of Barack Obama. Single home. It's the story of Tupac Shakur. Single home. You cannot come from a single home and be normal. Lewis Hamilton, same story. Either you become a force of ultimate good or a force of ultimate evil. Barack Obama and Adolf Hitler share same background. But one comes as a Hitler, one comes as an Obama. Mugabe, my wife was going to be a Catholic priest. Baba, I'm going to go hit and run. I'm going to go hit and run. Of course, I said it in a youthful way, but the facts are the same. It's just the packaging which is different, but it's... He's then sold and then goes to Egypt now. In Egypt, he works in Potiphar's house. So how then can you be a Joseph when Jacob is your father? Point number one. Rise above family politics. operate on a higher platform of the politics of heaven, where you don't operate from the family where you're coming from, but you're operating from the family of God in heavenly places. You have to be the point of difference. Because where you're coming from, it's known. Of course, that is over exaggerated. But you get the point. Such that if you go and start, if you just set yourself loose and become sexually promiscuous, no one will blame you. Munose rimi kuti kune vanhu vakasencha muchechi. Tatoti dismember. Nyaya yakazonogarirwa dare kumusha kwavo. Zvanzi akadzingwa kuchechi. Nzi vakadzingirwi. Hanzi akaita girlfriends. Zvakadzingira munhu izvozvo. Nekuti sekuru vacho vari kugara dare. Vatori neka 17 year old. And if you ask Nyari now here, she will tell you that Sekuru vatori nekesi underage. So, kananga akazwanira single mother yake handiti vanhu vanongowirira ndozvanga chechenyu chirungwa. So you are coming from a family where if you fail, even at what you do, no one will blame you. They say it runs in the family. So look at your shame, Siko, you know, like what you're saying in your testimony. You'll be shocked. No, dude, I have a girlfriend. It's a sham. It's a picture you're going to use. I'm not going to use a sham. It's a single mother. Angara mkazu we mune. Aiwa. Single mother. Ah, oh man. If Joseph had slept with Potiphar's wife, no one was going to blame Joseph. If they were going to sit as a family board, Sekuru Abraham wakadi. Mkoma Judah. Judah was worse because wakarane murora. Inda turarana first lady. Wemunika. People coming from families where if they fail, it's considered a success. Akazama. Akaita ma D5, nema DE, mamwe 2. 4 U's and 3 U's. Akazama. Ndi akaita wokutanga kunyora olevo. You are laughing. It's not a joke. You hear people here telling testimonies. Anigachinzi ndiwe kutanga kukwira ndege mhuri. Imi kwenyu, you know, we laugh at this. When I'm going to the airport, no, hapana anonperekedza. It's a non-event. Kwenyu iwe kwanzi uri kunokwira ndege.
Opportunity for others to come to Harare. There are people who are here who they are coming from families where the standards are so low,
such that when we say they have failed here, where they are coming from, they are the shining stars. So you don't judge people too harshly until you know where they are coming from. Baba wake wangu ni wakati 12. 12. Wakazi wa baba wake. Iye ari kutambura ne 2. Mototi no. Taimi. Dai mamboona kwadiri kubvawo. You would actually celebrate that I have done well. I have one official. Joseph had slept with Potiphar's wife, he was going to be promoted in the concentric circle of Potiphar's house. And this is what you do if you want to be a Joseph when Jacob is your father, is you need to raise the standard beyond and way above what has been set by the family to what is set by the family of God. So that you cannot be blessed according to Potiphar's house, you are blessed according to heavenly houses. So Joseph, either way, was going to be successful. But his success was determined whether according to the quality of Potiphar's house. Vice President. You become your boss's boss if you are faithful. If you choose to go according to family standards, you are going to be successful according to the boss's wife's definition of success. How to be a Joseph when Jacob is your father? You have to be excellent in what you do. See thou a man who's diligent at his work, he shall stand before kings. And in those who are more state of the dead, whatever that your hands find to do, do it with all your strength and with all your might. And you know, it's the temptations are no face. It's the same thing that your sisters are struggling with. You know, now your family is today. I went for a funeral. We knew this family when we were growing up, and we used to marvel because everyone in that family, they would sit down, father, mother, daughters and brothers, and they would drink and they would start fighting, and their neighbors will come and, you know, become United Nations there. Because that's where everyone else is failing. Chapter 39, verse 10. And his master's wife spoke to him day by day. So it was not like Joseph came into the house one day and Potiphar's wife says, Joseph, sleep with me. And Joseph said, no, I don't want. And Potiphar says, okay. No. Day by day. You have to struggle with inherited tendencies day by day. Where your father failed. You know, you grew up saying, I don't want to be like my father. I don't want to be like my father. Everything was clear. This is black, this is white. Now you are older, same age with your father. Exactly like your father. No more black, no more white, just gray areas. Now it depends. You have to succeed. Some kune vana vachatopiwa zita rako. Because you are the one who succeeded in the family. So you have to make it. You can't afford to fail. Because when you fail, there are 7 generations that are going to fail with you. You will be the reason why others are going to fail. You have to be the point of difference. The point where things stop. And that's Joseph. He became the point of difference where all the deception that you find in the whole family of Abraham ends with Joseph. He becomes the progenitor of new things and new beginnings. In closing, Joseph is faithful in the pit. Friends, you have to be the Joseph. So that when your kids look at you, you are the point of motivation. I want to be like my father. You know, all men here, they want two things. Either not to be like their fathers or to be like their fathers. And one of these days, my father. My father. That's my mom. Not referring to your sister or to your mother, referring to you. And where Garuto Lord has eaten me, a mother, it's a disaster. You have to be the point of difference. He's faithful in the pit. He's faithful in Potiphar's house. He's faithful in prison. Do you know when Joseph fails? And I love this because I love to talk about Joseph when he fails. So it is in the palace. All of that, the survivor, so. And you survive that. And humanity always survives the hard stuff of life. Mamu's Wajipa testimony. Chikaram Sheikh, you survive that. Humanity has power to survive dark times. Man's greatest, weakest point is not in times of struggle. It's when you're in the palace. Wazo graduate a man. Wa CEO. Ndiwa wakutonga. Ndiwa panutanga utora makapu. Achisa mabege wangu. It didn't happen when he was struggling. When he had arrived. When he was now calling the shots. When you need an appointment to see your own brother. Baba, God's okay. Reuben, Uya, those who used to be satanic. Because spiritual state are not permanent. Wheat are not wheat permanent and tares are not tares permanent. It can be changed. Reuben Uya becomes better morally than Joseph. Because Joseph, but not Maba, Reuben, they are not. He signed in Mjeri. Chitora Iwana wangu. Atende ukamanji. Before, he would sacrifice others to be accepted by others. Now, he wants to sacrifice himself to be accepted by God. Do you know no I to taka kura chitambara hama dzakwa baba wangu ini baba wangu ndo akachengeta vanhu vese kumuri kwedu pavakafa handina kana hama yangu yakandibadira fees ini izvino ndabudirira day after day phone call after phone call. Where were they when I was struggling? Wasika ka Joseph. Wasika manje vanhu vanokumusha havanzwisisi vanongouya no appointment vanongopfatika. You can't just be calling me for money every time. And you know, some of them know what they want. It's just a phone call from you. Because you are such a shining light in the whole family. That when you call them, the whole village is told. You didn't send a dollar. Maria urukurukwam soro, inende samwana kuchikoro gorerese. But Wasika Joseph, no. Where were they when I was struggling? Where were they when I was struggling? Is now a drug addict. No. We went through the same struggles. So, I mean, same mother, same father, you know. He's an adult. It's none of my business. Wasika